The objective of this video is for us to look at how insensitive the liquid properties, the state functions, are to changes in pressure. And to illustrate this, what I've listed are values for water at 50 degrees and 3 pressures. And so just quick view at these, you can see the volume, the enthalpy, and the entropy don't change very much for such a large change in pressure. And so I've calculated the percent volume change for this pressure change, and we can see it's the volume decreases, as we might expect for an increased pressure, but the change is significantly less than 1%. And similar values for enthalpy and entropy. So the percent change in enthalpy and entropy, entropy is pretty small. The biggest change is enthalpy. Enthalpy increases. The entropy, this is a negative sign here, decreases. But keep in mind, this is 100 atmospheres pressure. And then, of course, U, G, A, state functions, and also things like chemical potential and fugacity are not going to change much with pressure. And so it's reasonable, for example, if we want the internal energy of water, we will tend to use the value at saturation. So we'll use saturated liquid values, even though we're not at saturation conditions, we're at higher pressures. But if we go to the steam tables, we'll use the saturation temperature. So we'll find the enthalpy, or the internal energy, at the same temperature at saturation conditions, and then use that at higher pressures. And that's going to be a pretty good approximation, because we've just seen here that these values just don't depend very much on pressure.